In the previous video, we showed how the open circuit voltage of a crystalline silicon solar cell is influenced by the minority carrier lifetime. We discussed how the recombination rate can be reduced by keeping the defect density in the material to a low level and by passivating dangling bonds at the surface of the material. In this video, we will discuss several design solutions that can be implemented in crystalline silicon solar cells in order to increase this open circuit voltage. We will show how the recombination rate can be reduced by using a so-called selective emitter, and we will focus on the design of the so-called back surface field in order to reduce carrier recombination at the back contact. Considering again the overview presented in the previous video, we will continue with point 2, surface recombination, and then point 3, the recombination of charge carriers at a metal-silicon interface. In the previous video, we discussed how the recombination rate at the surface can be reduced by passivating the dangling bonds on the crystalline silicon wafer surface with a passivation layer. After applying this passivation layer, we can try to reduce surface recombination even more. As the surface recombination velocity is limited by the minority carrier concentration, this velocity can be reduced by lowering this concentration. The minority carrier concentration can be lowered easily by increasing the doping concentration of the emitter layer. At the same time, the conductivity of the emitter layer will be increased by the higher concentration of free electrons, indicated here by N. The resulting emitter layer will therefore have a lower resistivity. In addition, increasing the emitter doping concentration will reduce the contact resistance with the metal front contact, which is usually silver. In the video on thermionic emission of the PV energy conversion course, we have shown that the specific contact resistance between a metal and the semiconductor depends on the doping concentration in the semiconductor in case the dominant current mechanism across the Schottky barrier is determined by tunneling. By increasing the doping concentration, the influence of the Schottky barrier height phi Bn on the current flow is reduced. This becomes even more clear when we look at this plot of the specific contact resistance versus doping concentration for different metal-silicon combinations. Note that the work function of silver is comparable to that of aluminium with 4.26 volts and 4.28 volts respectively. Increasing the doping concentration of the emitter seems to be the perfect solution to take on surface recombination, emitter resistance and contact resistance at once, all resulting in a lower recombination rate. However, the increased doping concentration shortens the diffusion length of holes, minority carriers, in N-type silicon. This effect is substantial as the generation rate is highest near the surface of the solar cell, since photons in the blue part of the solar spectrum will be absorbed within the emitter layer. The holes will have to diffuse to the p-n junction in order to be separated and collected at the back contact. However, if the diffusion length is not long enough to reach the p-n junction, they will simply recombine in the n-type emitter and the external quantum efficiency for short wavelengths will be low. Increasing the doping concentration in the entire emitter layer is thus not a very good idea, but we are close to the advanced solution. Before we discuss this solution, we will first take a look at the interface between the metal and silicon in somewhat more detail. At this interface, the recombination rate is almost infinitely high, as the minority carriers will virtually instantaneously recombine with the free charge carriers in the metal. The design approach is therefore to reduce the contact area between the metal and the silicon. Starting with the standard design of a front contact on a passivated silicon wafer, the contact area of the metal and the silicon is reduced. On top of that, only the area below the metal-silicon interface will be doped with a higher dopant concentration. This design is called a selective emitter or selective contact, since the minority carriers will be repelled from the metal-silicon interface, reducing the recombination rate at the interface even further. This effect becomes clear when we look at the energy band diagram of the metal semiconductor Schottky barrier. By increasing the doping concentration below the contact, holes are repelled while electrons can still tunnel through the barrier and be collected. At the back contact of the solar cell, we have another metal-silicon interface where recombination losses can be substantial. This recombination results from inefficient separation of charge carriers in the wafer. Efficient separation of electrons and holes can be achieved by an electrostatic field, which is, for instance, created by a p-n junction. However, the p-n junction is located close to the front surface, and the electric field is only present in the depletion region near the metallurgical interface, which is usually a region of a couple of hundred nanometers. The wafer is hundreds of micrometers thick, which implies that the electrons and holes generated in the bulk of the p-type wafer do not feel this electrostatic field. In this situation, only a fraction of the electrons will reach the p-n junction and become collected. Some electrons will eventually recombine with a hole in the p-type wafer base. The solution to this is to introduce another electric static field by increasing the doping concentration near the back contact. This is called the back surface field, and this field repels electrons away from the back contact. The recombination at the back contact can be reduced further by following a similar approach as for the selective emitter, decreasing the contact area and introducing a heavily doped region close to the metal semiconductor interface. As a result, the back surface field increases the drift of holes towards the back contact while electrons are effectively repelled. The heavily doped region close to the metal semiconductor interface is created by heating the aluminium contact through the passivation layer. During this firing process, aluminium atoms will diffuse into the wafer and will act as acceptor type atoms, since aluminium has three valence atoms just like boron. Similar to the selective emitter, the effect on the energy band diagram of a metal semiconductor interface is clear. Electrons will be repelled from the back contact, while holes can tunnel through the barrier and be collected. In summary, we have shown that a higher emitter dopant concentration will result in lower surface recombination through a reduced minority carrier concentration and will lower the contact resistance between the metal contact and the silicon. A selective emitter reduces recombination losses at the metal semiconductor interface by implementing a heavily doped region just below the contact. In addition, the contact area between the metal and the silicon is reduced. Finally, we have discussed the introduction of a back surface field to improve electron and hole separation and facilitate improved collection of holes at the back contact by reducing the recombination rate at the back metal contact.